Good evening friends, in this video I will try to explain how to do projection of planes if the plane is inclined to both horizontal plane and vertical plane. Okay, I will take this question for our exercise. That is a rectangular plane ABCD of side 70 mm long and BC 30 mm has its side BC and HP. The plane is inclined 60° to HP and resting side BC is inclined at 45° to the VP. Draw the projection of the rectangular plane. Okay, so now I will explain the position of the given rectangular plane with the help of a note, and I will take this as the plane. Okay, this card as the plane, and I will use this note for setting this for showing the horizontal plane and vertical plane. Okay, so you can see here. This is vertical plane, this is horizontal plane. Okay, so they have told that the plane is resting on BC. Okay, so resting on BC now, I will take, assume this is A, this is B, this corner is C and this corner is B. Okay, now I am keeping this plane like this. On seeing this, you can understand that this plane ABCD is inclined to HP to an angle, to a random angle. Okay, and you can also see that BC is resting on HP. Okay, in addition to that, what they have given in the question is that the side BC is inclined at an angle of 45° to BP. Okay, so it may look like this. This angle, this BC, you can see that this BC angle is 45°. Okay, so this is the position of the plane they have given in the question. So for this, we have to see the front view and top view, and we have to draw the projection. Okay, so basically in a projection of planes, we have to start with normal position, then we have to go for first inclination, and third we have to go for second inclination. Three steps are there. So first, normal condition, without any inclination, we have to position the given plane. Okay, so if I keep this rectangular plane like this, okay, this is the normal condition as per our given question. So if when you see this plane from the top, we'll be able to see a rectangle. When we see this plane from the front view, we'll be able to see this line only, that will get projected to the vertical plane. So after that, if you rotate, this rectangular plane will become like this. Okay, next we have to draw an inclined position. If you see in the question, they have given two angles, that is plane is inclined to 60° to HP and resting side BC is inclined 45° to BP. So whenever there are two angles given in the question, first you have to draw the plane inclination only, then only you have to go for the side inclination. So first step in normal position, second step plane inclination, third step is side inclination. Okay, so we will see how to draw that manually. I will do that in my note in a rough manner. Then I will try to do the same thing in CAD software. Okay. They have given a rectangle ABCD. In that BC is 30 mm, and they are told that plane inclined to HP by 60°. Then side BC inclined to HP by, sorry, inclined to VP by 45°, and BC resting on HP. All these three conditions they have given. Okay, so first we will have to draw the reference plane. Just draw this reference plane and note it as X plane. Okay, so next we have to draw the rectangle, that is in top view position. So just draw a rectangle length 70 by 30. Okay, make sure that BC is here. This is A, this is A. Okay, next project this one to the reference axis. Okay, use this to differentiate. I will use red color pen for projection line. Okay, and blue color line for the line. Okay, so now we have to draw the top view. Sorry, we have already drawn the top view, then we have to draw the front view. Front view, as I shown in the first condition, it will look like a line. Okay, just draw a line over this reference line itself. Okay, next we have to number it. So just number it C dash
in bracket B dash. Likewise, D dash in bracket A dash. Okay. Why I am putting in B dash in bracket now? Because that corner is not visible. To understand in a simple manner, you can see here. Assume that you are seeing this corners from bottom. Okay, C is visible, B is not visible. So I have put B in the bracket, that is as it is a print view, I am mentioning it the dash. C is visible, so I am putting outside the bracket. Okay, likewise, if you see this corner, D is visible, A is not visible. So I have put this A in the bracket and B outside the bracket. I am using dash because it is the print view. Okay. Next, we have to draw first plane inclination. They told that plane is inclined to HP by 60 degree. We know that this is VP, this is HP, that you should remember always. Okay. Next, what you have to do now, just draw an inclined line. As I, you have to understand that if the inclination is HP, then in this note, we have to draw it in vertical plane. If the inclination is to VP, we have to draw that inclination horizontal plane. This is a shortcut you have to remember in order to avoid the confusion. So in the vertical plane, I am drawing an inclined line for 60 degree. Okay. Next, what you have to do now, we have to just from this line, we have to just project it over this line. We have to measure this line and just draw over this incline. So this will be the starting point. Measure this line length and cut an arc here. Okay. So this one will become C1 dash, this one will become B1 dash, D1 dash, A1 dash. Okay, next you have to draw projection line from this in the downward direction. Likewise, you draw a projection line from this side. Okay, so we just note on the meeting points. Okay, so from here D is coming, and D is coming and intersecting here. So this one should be D1. Okay, likewise, this one A is coming here, likewise, A is coming here. So this will be A1. B1 dash is coming down, B is coming here, they are intersecting at this point. So this will be B1, likewise, this will be C1. So as it is the top view, you have to draw, you have to notate without dash. Okay, this is the top view. Next, we have to draw this side inclination. They told that the side BC is inclined to VP by 45 degree. So we know this below the reference line only you are having horizontal plane. So that 45 degree should be drawn here. Okay, so just draw 45 degree line randomly here. Okay, just position this BC here. I'm taking a random point here. I'm taking another from here to here. What is the distance? Mark it here. Okay, from here to this CO, from B1 to C1, what is the distance? That has to be marked here. Okay, so this will become B2, this will become C2. Next, you have to draw a perpendicular line for the same length. Okay, so just draw a perpendicular line. From B to A1, what is the length you draw here? Likewise, C to D1, draw like this. Okay. See, don't get confused, as because of space constraint, I have drawn it roughly with a smaller value. But you have to measure what is the distance from B1 to A1, and you have to project it in this direction in a perpendicular manner. Likewise, C1 to D1, that distance has to be drawn here. Okay. Then join all these things. This one is A2, this one is C2. Next, draw perpendicular projection lines from all the corners. Okay, and then extend this projection line in this direction. Okay, this one in this direction, it will be coming over the XY reference line only. Okay, now we have to identify the meeting points. So this is B2, find where is B is coming here. So note on this point. Okay, this one is A2, where A is coming, this one. So it has to be, you have to mark this point. So this is C2, where is C is coming, this location. Okay, this is D2, I have marked it only, this is D2, okay. So D2 is coming here, D is coming here, so mark this point. Next, you have to just join all the corners. this will be what? A 2 dash, this will be D 2 dash, this will be C 2 dash, this will be B 2 dash. Okay, so this is the answer. So after this inclination to both the planes, in top in front view it looks like this, in top view it looks like this. Okay, so to summarize, I will explain again. There are three steps. One is in normal condition. From the normal condition we have to go for plane inclination, then from plane inclination we have to go for side inclination. Okay, so this is how we have to do the projection of the planes when it is inclined to both vertical plane and horizontal plane. Okay, thank you. Now we will do this same question in AutoCAD software. Okay, so first we have to draw the reference line. So just using line command, just draw the reference line. Make sure that auto is on. Okay, so I have drawn the reference line. Then we have to construct the rectangle. So using the same line command, I will construct the rectangle randomly. What is this distance? 30. This distance 70. Again 30. Then this distance again 70. So I have constructed a rectangle. Okay. Next we have to draw the projection line from each corner. Okay. Just extend this and extend up to this reference line. Excellent. Similarly, from this corner. Okay. So just draw a line from here to here. So this will be a front view, this will be a top view. Next, what you have to do now, we have to do the plane inclination. So randomly you can just draw a line from this point. Make sure that arco is off. You have to draw this inclination for an angle of 60 degrees. Okay. 60 degrees. So use a shift less than, sorry, again I am drawing, and I am selecting a point and reference plane. Okay, 60 degrees. What is the next one? That length is the same length. What will be this length? It will be 70, right? So just draw it for 70. Okay, what we did is that we have just made this front view at an angle of 60 degrees. Okay, next draw projection line from all the corners as we did manually. Just from here draw projection line. Okay, similarly from this corner for a random line. Okay, likewise you draw projection line from the top view. Extend. Okay, similarly from the other corner. Okay, so next you have to draw a line connecting all the corners. Okay, next we know that this is BC. Okay, to distinguish I'll just change the color. Front top you will make it as yellow color. Similarly, all the sides. Okay. And this is the front view. Front view, I will make it in red color. Similarly, this is the first inclination. That also, I will make it in red color as it is the front view.
Okay, then this is top view. I'll make it in yellow color. So you can see clearly, this is a top view, front view, plane inclination. This is the top view after plane inclination. Next, what you have to do now, we have to draw an incline line for 45 degree. Okay, just to draw line, switch off ortho. 45 now, what will be this angle? 315, 315, correct, 315. E15. So you can see this angle is 45. So when you are coming in the clockwise direction, it will be 315. And this line length should be equal to this length. So that is 70 mm only. Okay. That will be 70 mm. So draw it for 70. Okay. Draw, measure this distance. Sorry, I have made a mistake. Just draw an incline line for 45 degree. That is what you have to do. Okay. Next, what you have to do now, you have to measure this distance from here to here. What is the distance that we have to draw here? Okay. So, just select a random point here. Then you have to draw line in this incline line for this length. Okay, before that, what I do now, I'll just measure this distance. Okay, so I have found that this length is 30 mm only. Okay, so just we have to project, we have to draw this line over this incline line, that is, which is inclined at an angle of 45 degree to HP. Okay. Sorry, 45 degree to VP. Next, I will just draw a line from here, and this distance I will make it for 45. What is the line? 30. Okay, enter. Select this and change the color in order to differentiate. Okay, you can see that it is in yellow color. Okay, so what we have done is that we have drawn this line from this point to this point is drawn here. So we have to draw this perpendicular lines from BC. Okay, so use the line command. Shoot off FP. This line length is, I have already measured the dimension, it is around 35.35. Okay. Similarly from this end. It has to be maintained at that 90 degree. Okay. That is, this line should be perpendicular to this incline line. Okay, like that you have to draw. So enter the line length is 3.35. next, join the corners. Okay, next I will extend the projection line from all the corners in the upward direction, and we will finish up the front view. Okay, so use line commands, extend in this direction, make sure that the FAT is switched on. Similarly from this corner, So I have done, I have drawn the projection lines, just change the colors to avoid the confusion to blue color. Okay, next we have to, already I have drawn the projection line from this front view, that is also shown in the blue color. Now we have to find the intersection points. Okay, so this point is B, this point is also B, so we have to mark a point here using PO. Okay, this one. Okay, this point is C, so C is present here only, so that will be intersecting at this point. Okay, so like how we did in the manual drafting, same procedure, just name it before doing all this projection, then it will be easy for you to identify the correct intersection points. Then you can see here from this point. Okay, it is intersecting at this point, just use PO. Likewise from here to here, another point. So use PO and make a point here. Next to join all the points. Okay, change the color to red in order to understand that it is the front view. So this is the answer which we got already in the manual drafting. Okay, normal position, plane inclination, and then side BC inclination. This notation you can just follow whatever I have discussed in the manual drafting. Okay, thank you.